Yeah, I'm an artist. I'm working as a professional ballet dancer in Korea. Yeah, I have actually a question related with art and creation. So I personally need to often detach from my emotions and feelings. Sorry. So I need to do this quite often. I don't know, just my emotions can get like too wild somehow. And I feel that I had to need like to start a process of like detaching from my own thoughts and feelings in a way. But I feel when I do that, there's something very strong about it. Like I can feel it. Not only inside of me, I can feel it around me too. But at the same time, as an artist, as a ballet dancer, I feel that also as a creator, I feel like if there's no attachment to feelings, I feel there's no really creation. I feel if I don't really attach to emotions, to any emotion, there's no really something that I can create inside of me. I would just make something which it could be like beauty, but it, you know, that depth, it comes from attachment to my emotions and feelings. So I would like to ask you if there's a way to do not detach to it, so then I can like, you know, avoid suffering in a very like high level, but at the same time to be able to bring, you know, creation. Yeah.
간단한 비유를 들어서 먼저 말씀드릴게요.
So let's use an analogy.
네. 여기 선반위에 고구마를 합시다. 고구마가 있습니다.
So let's say that's a sweet potato, a yam on top of the shelf.
쥐가 이걸 봤어요.
There's a rat there, a mouse that looked at the yam.
안 그래도 배가 고파요.
And the mouse is hungry.
그래서 이 고구마가 먹고 싶습니다.
And the rat wants to eat the yam.
이 잘못된 겁니까?
Is that a bad thing?
No.
근데 만약에 고구마에 쥐약이 들었으면 어떨까요?
But what if the yam actually contained rat poison?
Well,
먹어야 될까요? 배고프더라도 안 먹어야 될까요?
Should the rat still eat it, or should rat, you know, refrain from eating it?
Well, I guess you could eat it.
네, 죽으려면 먹을 수 있습니다.
So if the rat wants to die, it can eat it. Yeah, right. You're right.
Yeah.
그러면 이 고구마를 먹지 말라 하는 게 진리가 아닙니다.
So the truth is not telling the rat not to eat the poisonous yam. That's not how you approach the truth.
그냥 쥐약이 들었다는 사실만 얘기하는 게 진리입니다.
So the truth is telling the rat, just informing the rat that there's food, there's poison inside that yam. Mm-hmm.
그러면 쥐는 살고 싶으면 안 먹고 죽고 싶으면 먹으면 되는 거.
Then the rat, it can make it to choose to live and not eat the yam, or it could choose to die and eat the yam. It's the rat's choice.
먹고 안 먹고는 쥐가 선택하는 거예요.
So it's the rat who makes that choice.
부탄은 다만 여기 쥐약이 들었을 때 쥐약이 들었다는 사실만 얘기하는 거예요.
So the Buddha's way of teaching is just informing the rat there is a poison inside that yam.
Okay.
그런 것처럼 자기 감정은 아무 문제가 안 됩니다.
So likewise, your emotions is not the problem.
감정 마음대로 표현해도 돼요.
And you can be free to delve into your emotions, express your emotions fully.
근데 만약 화가 났다.
But say you get angry.
뭐 화를 표현했다.
Then you can express your anger.
근데 나한테 아무 피해도 없다.
But there's no consequences to yourself.
그럼 뭐 마음껏 표현해도 괜찮습니다.
Then you can feel free to express your anger.
근데 내가 화를 냈다.
But say you get angry.
그러니까 내 건강이 나빠졌다.
And your health became bad because you expressed your anger.
아내가 괴로워서 그냥 집을 떠나버렸다.
Or your partner, your wife left the house, left you because she could not deal with your anger.
그래서 나한테 손해가 많이 생겼다.
So basically, expressing your anger brought about some kind of loss to yourself.
그럼 어떻게 할 거냐?
Then how would you make a choice then?
그러면 화가 나지만은 손실이 너무 크기 때문에 참아야 되는지 화를 so, 내야 되는지 그건 자기 선택이에요.
So should you suppress your anger and not express your anger then, or you should still engage and express your anger? That's your choice.
당신이 만약에 지혜로운 사람이라면,
if you are a wise person,
감정을 표현했을 때 손실이 너무 크기 때문에 감정을 내려놔야 되는.
So if expressing or indulging in your emotions creates too much loss for you to handle, then you have to suppress it or not indulge in your emotions.
당신이 감정을 그냥 표현하고 싶으면 표현하면 그 손실을 감수해야 되는.
But if you want to express your anger or your emotions, but willing to deal with the consequences, you know, and the suffering it brings you, then that's your choice to make as well.
어떤 길이 좋다 나쁘다는 없습니다.
So there's no good or bad choice here.
어떤 선택을 할 거냐는 문제.
It's only a matter of what you choose.
쥐가 이 고구마를 먹고 싶은 걸 먹고 죽을 건지, 배가 고프지만은 안 죽으려면 안 먹을 건지, 이건 쥐가 선택하는 거예요.
So whether rat wants to indulge in that yam but willing to die for it, or stay hungry but not eat that yam, that's the rat's choice.
그래서 뭐 화를 내지 마라 이렇게 하는 거는 화를 내는 게 나쁘다는 뜻이 아니라 손실이 크니까 내지 마라 이렇게 말하는 거예요.
So when I say don't get angry or don't express your anger, I'm not saying that anger in itself is bad. I'm saying that it actually brings about too much loss for you. So you should be more calculating on when to express your anger.
그러니까 감정을 표현해야 되느냐 안 해야 되느냐 이런 건 과제가 아니에요.
So the question you're asking, the essence of your question is not whether you should indulge or express in your emotions or not.
감정 자체는 좋은 것도 아니고 나쁜 것도 아니에요.
Because the emotions themselves are not good or bad.
감정을 표현했더니 이익이 생겼다 그럼 하면 되고요.
And if you express your emotions, it brings about a good benefit or profit, you know, to you, then it's a plus.
감정을 표현했더니 손실이 생겼다 그러면 표현하지 말아요.
But expressing your anger brings about a minus, then you shouldn't engage in it.
그리고 자기가 그 감정을 이렇게 춤으로 표현했더니 사람들이 다 좋아해서 나한테 이익이 생겼다. 그건 마음껏 표현하세요.
So if expressing your emotions through your dance, your artistry brings about joy to others and they give you satisfaction, then feel free to indulge in your emotions.
감정을 마누라한테 표현했더니 마누라가 막 가버렸다. 그러면 손실이 생겼다. 그러면 억제를 해야 됩니다.
But if you express your emotions to your partner, to your wife, and she left you, that's a huge loss, then you should suppress it.
Yeah. Thank you.
자꾸 여러분들은 나쁜 사람, 좋은 사람 이렇게 접근하면 안 됩니다.
So any problem, you cannot approach it from a good person versus bad person's perspective.
나쁜 사람, 좋은 사람은 없습니다.
There's no such thing as a good or bad person.
어리석은 사람, 지혜로운 사람은 있습니다.
As that is a wise person versus a foolish person.
자신에게 손해를 끼친 사람은 어리석은 사람이에요.
It's a foolish person who engages in behavior that brings about a minus to your life.
자신의 손해를 미연에 막는 사람이 지혜로운 사람이에요.
A wise person proactively refrains from engaging in behavior that brings about a loss.